Hello friends, today we are going to start the second chapter, that is Principles of Management, and today we are going to cover the topic of what is Principles of Management and what is its nature. So let's try to understand first meaning. The Principles of Management are the guidelines that help us to take decision. That means if you are a manager, you can take the help of these principles of management to take decision under different condition or different situation of organization. So in our organization, we are working in dynamic environment, so we always have to take some decision. Manager is taking decision at every step in the organization. So while taking decision under different condition, he can take the help of these principles of management. So he can take the decision scientifically. It is also considered as a fundamental truth. So fundamental truth means what? It is trying to establish the cause and effect relationship in principle of management. So ultimately what we can say, the principles of management are statements of fundamental truths which can be used by managers as a guideline or as an action under the different situations. Now let's try to understand the nature, but before that, here technique, fundamental principles of management is not technique, because technique is including steps or procedure to achieve the organizational goal. So these principles are not technique. At the same time, these principles are not a moral value. It is not related with any value or moral value, because moral value is a desirable one of the accepted or desirable human behavior. So it is not a moral value, or it does not have relation with values, or it is also not relation with any technique, because technique is a different thing, value is a different thing, and principle of management, they have also different meaning. Now let's try to understand the nature one after one. The first one is universal applicability. Universal applicability means what? These principles of management are applied to all types of organization. Whether you are a small organization, big organization, or medium-sized organization, government organization, non-government, private organization, public organization, profit-making, not profit-making, everywhere it is applicable. It is applicable even USA, Japan, or India, or any country of the world. It is applicable. Like division of work, one of the principle is there. It is applied everywhere. Every kind of organization can apply it to get the specialization of the worker. Second is general guidelines. So this principle of management, it is not giving you the ready-made solution. You have to make some modification in that according to your organizational situation, and afterwards you have to apply this. So ultimately we can say that it is only general guideline. It will give you some guideline, some understanding it will give you, but it will not provide you the ready-made solution. You have to take the reference of your experience and analysis, and according to that you have to apply this principles of management. Next is formed by practice and experimentation. So these principles of management have not been developed in one night. The principles of management developed by Henry Fayol and F.W. Taylor, this they have developed with their practice in their organization. At the same time, they have also done some experimentation in that their organization. Like F.W. Taylor has conducted the motion study, time study, fatigue study to increase the efficiency of workers. At the same time, the Henry Fayol has also done some observation. He has conducted some observation, and on the basis of that he has developed this principles of management. So we can say like this, these principles of management are formed by the practice and experimentation, observation on and observation. Another thing is these principles are flexible. So we don't have to apply this principle as it is. It is not a rigid. Why? Because you have to apply these principles according to the condition. What is the situation of your organization? And according to that, you have to modify the principles of management, and afterwards only you have to apply. Like division of labor is there. So division of labor may not be applicable in small firms. It is apply to the large firm only. That means it is applied to both, but the level of applicability will be different, because in small organization you have to divide into small group of people. In large organization the work may be divided into large number of employees. So like that way it is flexible. You have to apply it after modification according to your situation, according to your condition. So that's why you don't have to apply as it is. Like in science, principles of science, they are very static in nature. So they are applied as it is only. Afterwards only you will get the desired result. But here some modification is required. Next is mainly behavioral. So behavioral means what? Ultimately the what is the aim of these principles of management? The aim of these principles of management is to influence the human behavior. Why we want to influence the human behavior? Because we want to get the higher performance from them. So how we have to guide them in different situation? For that purpose we can take the help of principles of management. Like we are working in the dynamic environment of organization. In this, we have to decide that how much we have to apply. Means how much, at what extent we have to apply. Like we want to apply the division of work behavior, division of work principle. Unity of command is there, or discipline is there, or unity of direction is there. At that time, these all principles are trying to regulate or influence the human behavior. So manager will take the help of this all principle to regulate the behavior of the employees or workers. All right. So ultimately we can say that these principles are influencing the behavior of employees. Now cause and effect relationship. So some of the principles are there in the management which are establishing the cause and effect relationship. Here example is there, like division of work leads to specialization, or it will increase the efficiency of the labor. So division of work is a cause and efficiency will improve. That is the result, that is the effect. So like this way, these principles are also establishing the cost and effect relationship. Last one is a contingent. What is the meaning of contingent here? Contingent means it is applied according to situation. It is depending on the prevailing condition at a particular point of time. What is the condition of organization? It is depending on that. That means we don't have to apply these principles blindly. Not blindly we have to apply, but we have to see what is the condition. So we must have to apply these principles carefully, and it is depending on organizational requirement and situation demand. What kind of situation is there? On the basis of that only we have to apply. One example is that, like principle of unity of command is there. So it is relevant to a lower level and it may have a limited applicable in higher level. So when we are going to higher level, unity of command is not applicable that much. But when we talk about the lower levels, unity of command is must to get the desired results. So like this way we have covered all the points of nature of principles of management. These principles you can easily remember with the help of this word, that is BG Cafe. B means what? B means mainly behavioral. G means what? G means general guidelines. C means what? C is cause and effect relationship. A means what? A means universal applicability. Afterwards, F is there. F means flexible. What is meaning of E? E means what is here remaining here? E means formed by practice and experimentation. So like this way you can easily remember all this nature with the help of this word BG Cafe. Thank you, friends.